Welcome back to the Blue Door Pub Thunderdome. If you're another Boo Lady Girls, Minnesota's 87th best daily podcast, a show about everything and nothing, absolutely nothing at all. Coming at you 5 days a week. Happy Friday out there. Sin Shotgun is Uncle Nick. Follow him on Twitter at Nickerson. Hey, how's it going?
Going good, Andy. How you doing?
I feel like with the Monday off, well, a lot of people have Monday off, the short week, just hammering home, you feel like killing it, absolutely killing it. But I feel like probably said like 80% of the workforce did absolutely nothing this week.
I beg to differ. I worked my ass off.
Well, an anomaly. I feel like most people, they're like, oh, bro, it got so trashed on Memorial Day weekend. I'm just going to mail it in for a little bit. And then, so there goes Tuesday. Wednesday, maybe they get a couple things done. Maybe that tends to mean sure. Thursday, it's like, well, I mean, it's almost the weekend, right? And then Friday, ain't nothing getting done. I feel like that's normal corporate life.
That's why it sometimes makes me wish I would have gone corporate. You know, maybe we thought about a career path that could have gone and that kind of cliche stuff. But my brother was never a big fan of any of that.
Yep. Well, it's good to know that your brother makes your decisions for you, Nikki.
I do what I'm told.
Yeah. Well, there you go. Also, do what you're told by telling a friend, spreading the word about Bull with Andy Carlson. iTunes, Stitcher, iHeartRadio. Follow me on all the social medias at Andy Carlson Show on Twitter, on Instagram, on the Snapchat. And, well, it's Friday. And for some reason, this song stuck in my craw. And, yeah, I mean, beer in Mexico. I feel like the song was written by a robot, like SEO. Like, I want to, Nick, look up who wrote this song. Did Kenny Chesney write the song, or was it a collaboration of like, nine songwriters?
I'm on it. I think it's a collaboration. Yeah. A lot of country songs kind of work with, like, a group of...
Because I feel like country music, a lot of it's, like, Piper Perabo from Coyote Ugly, where she's got the chops, but she just wants to be a songwriter.
Ooh, Wikipedia says it is Kenny Chesney.
Oh, well, there you go.
So
he's underrated. I was confused. Oh, we missed the hook. Do my best, waste another day. Now, is he the one who was married to Renee Zellweger, or was like with her?
I'm looking it up right now. I get my Kenny Chesney's, Jason Aldean's all mixed up. They all seem the same.
No, see, Kenny Chesney and Keith Urban to me are the same, except even though he's Australian.
Australian.
Yeah.
Yeah, he married Renee Zellweger.
Oh, are they still together?
As of. Hands for an annulment.
Oh, wait. Hold on. I just saw this. Like, this is what happens, and this is why a lot of people, like, you either get 7-8 hours sleep, or you get 3. Like, there's really no in-between. And the reason that there's no in-between is because, you know, say you have to get up at like 6. Whether you go to the gym, you go to work for whatever. And so right about 10 o'clock, you're like, yeah, well, I should probably zonk out and get my 8 hours in. Or I can just click on this one YouTube video, or I'll read this one Wikipedia page, and then it'll be lights out. And then 4 hours later, you're like balls deep in like YouTube. You're like, you're reading about how the pyramids were built.
Oh, no, YouTube is my biggest... Achilles, Achilles heel, maybe the thing that like you can get immersed in it, like Wikipedia itself.
Yeah, it's Wikipedia and YouTube. Like, first you'll be looking up a trailer for the new Tom Cruise movie, like The Mummy, mm-hmm. and then at the end you're like, oh, so George Washington was a Freemason. Like 4 hours in, because I just saw this on the side, a trailer, Murder on the Orient Express, which was an old school movie, great film. And then I just saw a stupid Johnny Depp and his gosh darn stupid Mordecai mustache in it. And now I'm curious.
It's that sidebar though. It teases you. It gives you related topics and sometimes unrelated.
Because the original story was there was a murder on a train, and it turns out because the detective's on the train for some reason. Apparently that's his jurisdiction, or they could have just waited for the murder to happen outside of his jurisdiction. But I digress there. And there's like 13 suspects, but it turns out they all did it. They all really hate this guy.
Yep. Yeah. I've heard of that.
They all just took a turn on him, like they're running a train. Train. All right.
Spoiler alert for a movie from back in the day.
Well, this is what sucks when they do remakes of beloved movies, or just any movie that you already know the ending to.
You know, there is something about a tangle of strangers pressed together for days with nothing in common but the need to go from one place to another and never see each other again.
Stupid child. Oh, is the train going to derail? Maybe that's what they do.
I see evil on this train. A passenger has died.
Good for him.
Or her.
So they got him after
Professor
all.
Butler.
You assume he was killed?
The Count.
No.
The assistant?
Not. Well, he was in perfectly good health. He had his enemies.
Indeed. He was murdered.
God.
The governess.
God rest his soul.
The missionary.
Someone was rummaging around my cabin in the middle of the night. No one would listen to me.
If there was a murder...
What is going on?
Then there was a murderer.
Maid
salesman. The murderer is with us.
The doctor.
And every one of you is a suspect.
But it's a princess.
And who are you?
My name is Hercule Poirot, and I am probably the greatest detective in the world.
Oh, God, that was Kenneth Branagh.
Yeah, Kenneth Branagh. Wild West.
This is an all-star cast.
Yeah.
It has, Josh Gad, my favorite.
Yeah, he was the assistant, because of course he is, because there's no way that he's the number one.
Ooh, Michelle Pfeiffer. Daisy Ridley. Oh, my gosh. Oh, yeah, Daisy Ridley.
She needed work.
She's in Star Wars. She's way.
Yeah, I mean, but what has she done lately?
I hate you. All right. Penelope Cruz.
Yeah. Also, someone who's done a lot lately, Josh Peltz, Remax Preferred. Just hung out with Josh. He came out after The Football Machine. Love that guy. He's awesome. He's busy. And that's a sign of a good realtor. It's also a sign, if you have a lawyer that you can't get a hold of on the phone, that's a good sign. Because that means that he or she is busy. They're working. Josh Peltz is the same way. But hey. He'll actually pick up his phone. That's the difference, yeah. 763-213-4617. He's showing a bunch of great houses around the Twin Cities. He will get you into the house that you want for the best possible price or sell your house. It's a seller's market right now. Get you top dollar for that house. And, yeah, I mean, he's just the best. JoshPelto.com or shoot him an email, josh.pelto@remax.net. Josh Pelto, Remax Preferred. All right, so Friday, we got How Old They Be, TV Cop Edition. That should be a lot of fun. Producer Al has been busy. I still can't believe that you two haven't met.
We don't have a schedule to meet, I guess. I don't know.
That's true. Because, I'm a big proponent that meetings are complete BS. And especially with the internet now, and like everything can be done remotely. I feel like 99%, well, not 99, I would say 35% of all jobs could be done remotely nowadays.
I might go 25.
Because, you know, that's the big thing, especially parents of young kids. And, you know, we're in that boat. And if we had to pay for childcare, that would be an ass load of money. I know that couples do it. Sometimes they got two or three kids. And, you know, they talk about when they're able to work from home, they're able to watch the kids, able to save the money. And it's something that I'm really blessed that I'm able to do. It saves a lot of money and spend a lot of time with Muggsy as well in these fun formative years. And, yeah, I feel like if you're like tech support, you could do that from home. If you're a project manager, you could do that from home. You got email, you got HD webcam, you have this thing called a phone, and you have Slack. I mean, what else do you need?
Slack. No, I hear you. I mean, a lot of telemarketing jobs, there's a lot of lot of great things out there, I guess. A lot of opportunities, business world-wise.
Yeah, yeah. But, yeah, you can't do your job from home. You don't want to bring your work home with you, Nick.
No. I'm a, you know, sciences and, you know, a lot of, like, trade stuff, you know, plumbing, technicians. I mean, that stuff you really can't do from home. But, yeah. I mean, I'm sure there's a lot of unique things, like interior design stuff. I mean, a lot of people can, like be out for a couple hours, but then spend most of their time, you know, working at home in their office or something.
Yeah.
I assume a lot of people might be more of, like, kind of that, like, part-time at the office, and then, you know, most of the time maybe enjoy it at home.
I feel like salespeople do a lot of their stuff out of the office, as well they should be. They should be out, you know, making leads run, closing sales and whatnot. Josh, you know, realtors, I mean, they're never, they don't even have an home office usually. Like there's never, it's not like Glengarry Glen Ross where there's a, cause that was real estate, right?
Yeah, that was real estate.
Yeah. Cause there's not like a home office where you got stupid, John Lemon, Jack Lemon, you know, like sipping on the coffee, Alec Baldwin says, put that coffee down. No, I mean, they're all mobile. I mean, they're all setting up open houses. Well, hopefully they are.
I mean, it is nice for them to have that, like, space. But, I mean, but yeah, a good person would be out most of the time. Hence what, who was the other, who was the main seller, the big seller one? Pacino, I think he was the one out. You know, he wasn't in the office at all. He spent his whole time at a diner trying to convince this guy to sell, to buy some property.
Smooth segue. I saw this trailer for Logan Lucky. It's by the producers of the Ocean's 11, 12, 13 movies. And I'm not going to lie. This is going to be a great movie. I can't wait for this. From the director of Ocean's 11, 12, 13 and Magic Mike.
Jimmy, I'm just going to say it. I got to let you go.
Channing Tatum.
You were just fired.
Two brothers. What's the name of that guy?
That's Adam Driver.
Shot Khan.
Shotgun, what?
All right, fine. Han Solo's kid, spoiler. Don't care.
Kylo Ren.
Don't care. I honestly, if someone is pissed that he's like, I don't care. I don't.
It's Adam Driver who plays Kylo Ren from the new Star Wars movies.
Matt sucks.
Very underrated.
So, for liability reasons involving insurance.
The one-armed bartender.
You need to show a little respect.
Charlotte Motor Speedway.
Hold on. So obviously the big race is Daytona. You know, the Daytona 500, that's their Super Bowl, even though it's at the beginning of the season, which I never get right. And you know, when you're shooting a NASCAR-esque movie, here they're at Charlotte Motor Speedway, which is a fine racetrack. It's not the you know, the premier one. And then like Talladega Nights, there was obviously a Talladega. And they have to build up these secondary tracks and races because that's where they could get the rights to film.
Yep.
Yeah. Because I'm sure they would love to rob the Daytona 500, except that would have inflated the budget like 2x.
Yeah.
Yeah. But all right. Yeah, all right. All right.
I know how they move the money.
We should just have a show where
we analyze trailers the whole time.
Yeah, I just pause like every 2 seconds. It would be very annoying to watch a movie with me, which we're going to do after this.
The only guy who knows anything about blowing up real bank vaults is Joe Bang.
I am incarcerated.
Yeah, we got a plan to get you out.
Daniel Craig, bleach blonde. Worst southern accent of all time. But I think that's intentional.
The Coca-Cola 600 is the biggest race of the year.
We need computer whiz.
I know everything there is to know about computers, okay? All the Twitters, I know them.
Welcome.
This is basically Ocean's 11. But I'm okay with that.
A fun version of it.
That's such a good version.
For the Coca-Cola 600.
How many yards away is the vault?
20 yards. I don't know, maybe 30.
Is it 20 or is it 30? We are dealing with science here.
They're gonna know what we want them to know.
My life of crime is over.
massively stupid.
Seth yeah. MacFarlane. Yeah.
It's been handled.
Oh, this is going to be good.
That looks like it hurt.
Oh, wow, Sebastian Stan.
I want everything on Jimmy Logan.
I'm about to
introducing
get naked. So no bacon. I said no bacon.
You Logans mustn't be as simple-minded as people say.
There were white, black stripes.
Say that.
Would you give me my arm, please?
Is it this one?
The prisoners were wearing black and white stripes. I don't think that's
not a
comically
thing
that's a comically great.
No, but it's you know, it's from an Ocean's movie, so it's very deliberate. But I can't wait to see that movie. I also can't wait to beat your ass in How Old They Be.
Celebrities are old.
69, dudes.
The question is, how old?
Get off my lawn.
Time for another rousing round of How Old They Be.
I can't let you in because you're old as fuck. For this club, not, you know, for the earth.
Every time. Every single time. So here is the game. Today we have 12 names of TV cops. Play along at home. Nick and I will each guess how old they be. We have it set up where we can't see the age. We see the names. I always guess first. Nick guesses second. And away we go. Well, Nick writes his answer down so he can't play off of mine. That's how we roll. Play along at home. Tweet in your scores. Yeah, to have some fun with it. How old? Ooh. I always forget to play the pyramid music. All right, so the first one. Producer Allie outdid herself. The first name of How Old They Be TV cops, Seamus Dever, who played Kevin Ryan on Castle. Seamus Dever. I don't know who this is.
I watch Castle. If it's the one so the TV show Castle on ABC, Nathan Fillion and what's her name? Stacey Kanick. So sorry with names. They were like the two main, the kind of like, you know, the whole will they, won't they kind of hook up, get together, spoiler alert, they do. Yep. I think Kevin Ryan was one of the side officers.
Okay. So I'm at a disadvantage, but that's okay. That's part of the game. I'm going to guess.
I'm totally guessing.
45.
I said 43.
Good. Thank goodness. Because I thought you'd be like, ha, asshole, he's 70. Seamus Dever is 40. There we go. Yeah, I'll take that. Next up, 2 out of 12. Eric Estrada, the OG, as in original, not gringo. Officer Frank Ponchirello in Chips, the TV edition, not the really crappy movie, which, you know, I'm going to see it when it comes out on DVD. I'm sure it's fine, but man, that thing got panned bad.
Which I feel bad because, I mean, it has a. They're really good actors in there. I think Dax Shepard is very underrated. I think he's a fantastic guy. And I forgot who played Eric Estrada's character.
The Mexican guy and everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That guy.
Yeah. All right. So Eric Estrada, old, but how old? Like, if you said 69, I would believe it. Sure. I'll go 65.
I went 65 too.
Yeah. Eric Estrada is 68.
Oh, you went closer with 69. That's interesting.
Always go 69. Just like with Melissa Fumero.
Oh, Santiago, I love Amy Santiago.
Brooklyn 99. Yeah, the Brooklyn 99, it's a great show. I think Andy Samberg and them really hit it out of the park. Terry Crews is the latest on that show too. This is the new. Well, if there was three channels like there was back in Gilligan's Island days, this would be the new Ginger or Marianne, Santiago or Rosa.
Yeah. Oh yeah,
yeah. Because it's like, sometimes like. I buy in their personalities. Like, you want to be Santiago in the streets, but Rosa in the sheets?
Yeah, yes.
Yeah, you know what I mean? All right, so Melissa Fumero.
She was also on, like, Days of Our Lives. Yeah. One of those. all my children. Yeah,
she looks young, except I think she's going to be surprisingly older. I think she has a kid. She's married. I'm going to say...
She had a kid during the show. They hit it very well.
I'm going to say 36.
I said 32.
32. Mosa Fumero is 34.
Off in the middle.
Next up, 4 out of 12, Shalita Grant. Shalita Grant. Oh, yeah, 5-point bonus, 5-point deduction if you get it right on. Shalita Grant played Sonia Percy in NCIS New Orleans. Shalita Grant. I have no idea who this is.
I don't know who this is either.
All right, so that's fair enough. So when we have no idea who someone is, we look it up because we figure that's fair game.
Visually, not like let's look up on Wikipedia because obviously that's the first thing you fucking see. So.
So
Google imaging, just straight up the name.
Yeah. Shalita Grant.
Height.
Oh, she's a good looking lady. Okay.
The problem with pictures is we don't know if they're from this year. these could be shots from the 90s. Yeah. I have no idea.
Deadlifter. Jealous. All right. So Shalita Grant.
We're doing this on Visual Basics, and I'm so sorry, Shalita. If I.
Hey, how dare you? I'll say 44.
I said 42.
42.
I think she's older.
Shalita Grant is 28.
Oh my God. No.
Shalita, I'm so sorry.
We should just delete this one completely.
Next up, Rashida Jones, who plays... Oh, well done, producer Ellie. Angie Tribeca in the show Angie Tribeca, which I have not seen, even though this should be right up my alley.
The problem, which I'm not jumping on the show right away yet, is it's one of those... I see ads on Facebook all the time for it, so I feel like I've seen and watched a show without ever seeing or watching the show because there's so many ads. But it looks very...
It's like Naked Gun-ish.
Yeah, to the extreme. So,
all right, so Rashida Jones, also on Parks and Rec, also in The Office, which is a great parlay for her. Also, she produced the Netflix documentary Hot Girls Wanted about the porn stars. Did you ever watch that?
I did not.
It's got one of my favorites on there. All right, so Rashida Jones.
Okay, done.
Daughter of Stevie Wonder.
No.
Fine, Quincy Jones. Rashida Jones, I'll say she's... that's the wrong one. 42.
I said 40.
40. Rashida Jones is 41.
Wow, round it.
Ooh. Next up, your girl.
I love her.
Diane Kruger, who played Sonya Cross in The Bridge, which kind of underrated show. It was a remake of, I believe it was a Danish show or Scandinavian show. It was
okay.
She had Asperger's on the show. Like, that was really important for some reason.
Yeah, okay.
All right, so Diane Kruger... National Treasure, also Inglourious Bastard. She gets choked out. she's been around for a long time.
She was dating, what's his name, from Dawson's Creek, Joshua Jackson for the longest time. They were like together for the longest time. I think they just broke up.
I feel like Joshua Jackson definitely goes after the older women. Like, I feel like that was written into, because didn't he sleep with a teacher on the show?
Yeah.
Because he didn't want to wait for his life to be over. So Dan Crew. I think she might be sneaky older. Like, I feel like Diane Kruger, Mellencamp, is pretty apt. I'm going to say she's 46.
I said 38.
30. Oh, this could be it. This could be big. She's 28. I'm so sorry, Shalita. Diane Kruger is 40. That one hurt. That one hurt. I'm going high. I'm going high. Next up is Niecy Nash. Niecy Nash, who played Deputy Renisha Williams on Reno 911. That was a good show.
Was she the short brunette-haired one?
No, she's a black lady.
Oh.
Yeah. She's hilarious. I think she's one of my favorite. I lost my virginity to an episode of Reno 911.
Okay. I never got into the show.
Yeah.
I'm kind of pulling this blind.
So. Yeah, so let's see. 2003. No, maybe it wasn't an episode of Reno 911. Anyways, all right, so Niecy Nash, I'm going to say 42.
I said 51.
Just Niecy Nash is 47. Oh. I am bad at this. I'm bad today.
I might have a slight lead.
Thank you, dude.
I haven't been doing the math.
Five names to go. Holly Robinson Pete. Holly Robinson Pete, who played Officer Judy Hoffs on 21 Jump Street.
I have no idea what this is.
All right. She's also on Hang with Mr. Cooper. Married to Rodney Pete, former Detroit Lions quarterback, and also Eagles, and also USC legend. All right, so Holly, she's
I'm assuming
older.
She's Johnny Depp age. I'm assuming she was Delzo and other characters.
Yeah, I'm going to go.
Wait, not yet. Talk for like 10 seconds.
Although, yeah, Hang with Mr. Cooper. That was an underrated show. Played for the Warriors before the Warriors were cool.
Who was Mr. Cooper? Was that
Mark Curry. Yeah.
Yeah, I do.
I think that's the only thing he's ever done.
Besides,
like, stand-up comedy specials and maybe a cameo here and there. I think that's the only thing notable. Like, I can't even name one movie that he's in.
Yeah, he kind of disappeared off the face of the earth. All right, I won't number down.
I'm going to say 51 for Holly Robinson.
I said 48.
48. Holly Robinson Pete is 52. Nice.
Oh, nice.
Nice. Four to go. Next up is Adam Rodriguez. Adam Rodriguez, who plays Eric Delco on CSI. Miami. Who are you?
I don't know who he is.
I don't know who this is either. All right, so that's fair. Adam Rodriguez to the Google image search.
I'm assuming he will be the only Adam Rodriguez that shows up.
No, we'll look up CSI. There we go. Adam Rodriguez. All right. Good-looking dude. I recognize him. All right. Guys are always sneaky old, though. I'm going to say, you got yours?
Okay, I do.
I'm going to say 38.
I said 46.
46.
That's good, wake it.
Adam Rodriguez is 42.
Like in the middle. Exactly in the middle.
Yeah. Next up, three to go. Here we go. Kira Sedgwick.
Mrs. Kevin Bacon.
Who played Brenda Lee Johnson on The Closer, which is another show that got a lot of critical acclaim. I never watched a single second of.
Neither have I. It was on forever on, was it TNT?
Yeah.
USA.
It was a great show. Leverage.
I've never seen that.
Okay. What?
No. Kidding. I follow them all now. That's cool. Yeah. Like, you can see them all. They're all working.
Parker was married to Jason Lee.
Yeah, they had a kid together. And
Timothy Hutton was on American Crime. That got canceled. Hardison.
He's in Underground.
Yeah, the show about slavery. He was also in Straight Outta Compton. He played MC Ren up in this mother. Mm-hmm. The long-haired dude is on The Librarians.
Yes. I've been meaning to eventually maybe kind of look at that show. Yeah. Because because the woman who played Parker cameoed in it or something. Like, she played a role.
Did they do a joke? It's like, do I know you?
I don't know. I haven't seen it.
I feel like they should because it's the same writers and producers, right?
I know. That's what...
I love when they do that. I love when the wife from Home Improvement made an appearance on Last Man Standing.
Yep. Jonathan Taylor Thomas even made an appearance, too.
Well, now we have to YouTube those. All right, so Kira Sedgwick. I'm going to say 62.
I said 50.
Kira Sedgwick is 51. I think it might be dead. I think it might be dead.
There's two more left, and these actually might be struggles.
All right, so two to go. Kira Sedgwick. Kira Sedgwick also lost a lot of her money to Bernie Madoff. Very sad. Two to go. Jimmy Smits, who played Detective Bobby Simone on NYPD Blue, also played a reform born-again gangbanger on Sons of Anarchy. Was banging Gemma Teller for a while. It was a good cameo. It's good stuff. All right, so Jimmy Smits.
Star Wars.
That doesn't count.
I hate you.
Man, NYPD Blue was a good show. I remember, Sipowicz. Speaking of guys who never did anything else, Dennis Franz. Like, what was it?
Is he still alive? He might not even be alive anymore.
Like, Dennis Franz. Like, yeah. Did he do a Funny or Die? Like, I don't know. All right, so Jimmy Smits. I'm also 58.
That's a 55.
Jimmy Smits is... 61. Ugh. I should have gone with my gut. I was going to go 60. Oh, we'll work it out. All right, so I'm pretty confident Nick has a lead. We got one name left.
Barely league. We'll see. Andy will still win this because he's Andy.
Allison Tallman played Molly Salverson in Fargo. Molly Salverson in Fargo. Now, I don't know who this is.
I don't know who this is.
All right, so we're going to look up the... let's see. We're going to look up Alice. I wonder if she's the heavyset gal from the first season who ends up with... the chick who ends up with Colin Hanks. I haven't seen season two.
I have not. From what I know of the show Fargo, I think it's one of those rotating cast shows. I think what True Detective kind of did.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I don't know if anyone's staying with it or not. So I don't know.
I just remember Billy Bob Thornton was the shiz. He was fantastic. Yeah. Yeah.
Wait, can I see the picture one more time?
Oh, yep. All right, so Allison Tallman. Okay. She kind of looks like Blossom's like older sister.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. All right.
I wrote a number down.
So Allison Tallman, I've been shooting high all game on the females, which is very, very bad. But she's 30s. She might go 40. So I'll just go right in the middle. I'll split it. I'll say 35.
I said 43.
35. Nick said 43. Allison Tallman is 35.
Wow.
Oh.
That's the one Andy needed. Oh. And Nick.
That might be big.
That might have cost me the game.
All right. Hold on.
That might have cost me the game.
Gotta breathe. Actually, let's take a break. Let's get the results on the flip side of Bo with Andy Carlson. Oh, loud it. Andy Carlson here, Purple for the Win podcast, letting you know that we'll be here all off-season long talking the Vikings angle on everything. Combine, pro days, free agency, the draft, OTAs, training camp in 2017. Baby. Get the show on 1500 ESPN Podcast 1 and the Podcast 1 app. And come back into the Blue Door Pub Thunderdome, waiting on the results. Nah, this is just like at the hospital, Mick. We don't know who won. I hit Allison Tallman out of the park.
Yep, and I was not close.
Although I screwed up pretty bad during the game.
I don't know. That last one, I bet we should calculate it before that last one and then after. I'm pretty confident.
Yep. So, something you shouldn't screw up, though, is this Saturday. Tomorrow, as you listen to my voice, or maybe later in the day if you're listening to it on Saturday, get your ass down to Upper Park Landing Brunchapalooza. Our friends at Blue Door, High Low Diner, putting it on. They got music, they got food, they got drinks. You've heard me talk about it a lot. $69, nice. Gets you a full day of eating, drinking, merriment, and music. Rain or shine, it looks like it's going to be shine. Which is going to be good. Upper Park Landing right off the Miami, Mississippi. Brunchapalooza, Blue Door Pub, Hilo Diner. More details at thebdp.com. All right, Nick. So here we go. So we're subtracting 5 points off of my score. So I come in at a svelte 52.
Okay.
Respectable.
I'm going.
Not bad.
B50. 5-0.
And remember, low score wins. So if Nick is under 52... he's our champion. Nick has 52. Oh my God.
We tied. That cost me the game.
Oh, that's last amazing. One. Oh, if you would have said 42 for Allison Tallman, that.
Yeah.
Oh.
Wow.
That's amazing.
I still have not won.
Yep.
I won once out of like.
Yeah.
I'm happy we tied. I'm happy. Happy I wasn't like in the 80s or 90s like I usually am, so. I am heartbroken for that one woman that we were completely off.
Well,
because
what happened is that obviously Shalita Grant is a beautiful and talented woman, but the last picture that we looked at, it almost looked like an age progression picture. Like it was not the best picture of her. I think that's stuck in our minds.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like,
good point.
I understand why they do it, but it always makes me sad. Like when they do age progression pictures, like of Jacob Wetterling, it's like, Like that guy should be out, like, trying to sell me a new air conditioner right now. Sad. Yeah. Someone's not sad as the news.
You are fake news.
Sir,
go ahead. Can you...
George Bush doesn't care about black people. America.
I ain't got time to bleed.
You can't handle the truth.
The news with Uncle Nick.
All right, Nick, what's going on in the world today?
The news actually is kind of sad.
What?
I'm kidding. Okay. All right. The top story of the last week has kind of been the resurgence of former golfer great Tiger Woods.
I wouldn't say resurgence. Not like he went out and won anything.
Anyway, a big story in the news is that he was arrested on Memorial Day in Florida for suspicion of driving under the influence. We're recording this on Thursday, and a lot of news is still kind of coming out. But as of late, he wasn't. There's no alcohol involved, but it seems to be an issue with prescription medication.
He takes a couple uppers.
Yes, I mean, because his car was found parked on the side of the road. So, I mean, driving, I mean,
he takes a couple of downers.
A lot of questions with that. If anyone's in the law industry, they can explain it to me more later.
But nothing compares.
but he was
his blue and yellow purple bills.
He was found by himself in his 2015 Mercedes Benz.
Yeah,
and he got cited for DUI and improper parking.
Yeah, no, he was passed out.
Yep.
You're coming from Jupiter, Florida?
Yes.
Okay, do you know where you're going?
No.
You're just driving around or what?
I like to drive.
I'm sorry?
I like to drive.
You like to drive?
Just go to the Minimalist.
Okay.
Walk the golf course and like that.
Yeah, okay. So just by the sound of his voice, and obviously this is just anecdotal, this is not a drunk guy. This is a guy who is completely like strung out on a pill cocktail. And see, I want to know if the officer recognizes him, because he seems like a younger officer, and yeah, this was early in the morning, right? And younger officers are usually stuck with the graveyard shifts. So This guy, probably fresh out of the academy, maybe is 26, 27. Tiger hasn't been good in a long time, so I don't know if this officer even knows who he is.
It's quite possible, and... Yeah, as I said, I mean, what timing right now? I mean, I don't know if any of you guys are big golfer fans, you know, but I was, and, you know, I was always cheering on Tiger Woods. He was very exciting to watch. But, I mean, you know, his career is kind of faded now, and this is something that it did not need right now. This is the worst timing ever.
Well, it's, he was so dominant. And we'll never see this level of domination in golf again. I mean, we just won't. And I know that Jordan Spieth and Rory McIlroy and Bubba Watson, they're all good and nice and all, except they just don't have Tiger's star power. And I don't see golf, barring like some miracle, just like guy comes like a shot out of nowhere and comes out and dominates again.
Like a Korean hotshot who just won the, I think, Masters a few weeks ago.
No, Sergio won the Masters.
No, who was the Korean guy? Was it maybe it was the U.S. Open?
Yeah, it doesn't really matter.
Right, anyway, but
Asians are really good at golf. All right, I wonder what happened to me. But yeah, just imagine the double life of Tiger. Like when he was just dominating out there, like winning the Masters by a dozen strokes, and then he was just he had his assistant just like lining up Denny's waitresses and just slaying.
The mugshot. I mean, the mugshot now is the infamous meme right now.
Yeah. The mugshot's amazing. Oh, let's hear some more of that.
Have you had anything to drink tonight?
I'm not.
Are you sure?
Yes.
100%?
100%.
He wasn't lying.
Left foot and then right foot with your heel touching your toe of your left foot.
Is this legal?
All right. Make your right foot heel touch your toe. Okay. No, stay there. Stay back.
Because his car was pretty effed up. Like the rims were smashed. Like the front end had a bunch of damage to it. So he'd obviously, like...
That could have been the ex-wife, though.
He needs to not drive SUVs on holidays. Because when the adultery thing broke, he was driving a black SUV on Thanksgiving. And then...
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Then Elin, did she go three-wood? I think she went three-wood.
No, I see her as an Iron Girl myself, but...
Yeah.
It was a great SNL skit, by the way, with... who was it? I think Blake Lively played Elon, and they got, what's his name? They got Kenan Thompson being Tiger Woods, because that's all they could do at the time, you know? when she kept beating him up.
Yeah. No, she got Jay Farrell.
In golf, this was early, the lowest.
It was early, though, but, man, the mugshot, though, I mean, it's just... Like Tiger back in the 2000s.
I have not been.
Tiger back in 2000s, and then you look at this picture now, just a broken, just, it's just so sad. I mean, I know a lot of his money was gone, but, I mean, he still has quite a bit of money. Uber it. Take an Uber.
I don't even think that this was a money. I feel like most DUI, especially, you know, people who are well off and athletes and actors, like, it's not about the money. It's about, hey, no, it's always something stupid like, hey, man, I don't want to go get my car tomorrow. As stupid as that sounds, I know,
which is ridiculous.
Yeah, I don't think we're going to be able to find it.
Like a straight up, yeah, it must be copyrighted or something.
Oops.
But,
like, we care about copyright around here. I'm just kidding. All right, what's next?
All right. Second news story comes out, Washington Post. A Denver columnist has been fired for a tweet that he said about a Japanese driver who won the Indianapolis 500 over the weekend. Let me get the name. Terry Fry, or Free. I'm really sorry if I'm totally butchering your name.
It doesn't matter. He's not working.
who's been a sports writer in Colorado forever. Lost his job because, I'm going to see if I can pull up the tweet here, but he tweeted, nothing specifically personal, but I am very uncomfortable with a Japanese driver winning the Indianapolis 500 during Memorial Day weekend.
This is about America.
Yeah, and to backtrack a little bit, Takuma Sato won the Indianapolis 500 the day before Memorial Day.
Yeah, I wish I'd been paying attention because I could have gotten so many Asian driver jokes because I'm allowed to make them. Yeah, what? like an Asian winning a driving contest. That sort of bugs me. It really does. I see his point. But no, but he... Oh, it's even better with some Spanish. No, everything really is better in Spanish.
Y eso le ha hecho levantar un poquito el pie del acelerador y le da un margen de respiro también a Takuma Sato.
Gol.
Ahora se ha alejado un poquito.
Porque ahí tenía que levantar un poquito el pie del acelerador.
Let's get the end. There we go.
Ahora sí, ahora sí. Vale, vale, hemos recuperado. Estamos viendo cómo entra precisamente el coche de Oriol Servia.
Primer japonés que lo consigue.
Does that mean he wins?
Pues vamos a ver, porque Castroneves quiere buscar su cuarto título. Sato el primero.
Understood, Castroneves.
Vuelta tres, curva tres, perdón.
There he is.
Curva cuatro. Sato que aguanta.
Oh, ojo, there he goes.
Todavía no ha dicho su última palabra Helio Castroneves, entrando en recta de meta. Va a ser la victoria para Takuma Sato, victoria para el equipo Andretti. Takuma Sato consigue la victoria en la edición 101 de las 500 millas de Indianapolis por delante de Helio Castroneves. Primer japonés que...
Dun, 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 dun. Oh. No, I mean, that's awesome, though, because, you know, the whole Asian stereotypes of Asians can't drive. Eat it.
You know, and I'm not a big fan of NASCAR, so I know very little of Indy 500, except that, you know, those race cars are sweet, and I think I had them all as, like, micro machine cars when I was a kid, you know, racing down the track. And...
You know, it's a super underrated movie. Stallone. Oh, Driven.
Driven?
Yeah. It's Stallone. It's the guy who played Sunshine in... And Remember the Titans? He's like the up-and-coming hotshot driver. He's like the Tom Cruise. The guy who plays Hugo Stiglitz in Inglourious Basterds plays the German driver named Brandenburg.
Oh, okay.
No, now we just need to find the trailer. Because I might make you watch that movie instead. This is a very underrated movie. This is a fantastic movie. Also, you know the main song from the soundtrack was Tantric Breakdown? I know the breakdown. Everything is going to shake now someday.
I only have volume out of one ear, so I can't, I can't hear everything.
Let's pull up it, everyone. This one sucks. All right, there we go. Stallone. Driving Indy cars. Indy cars. Oh, yeah. And hold on. From the director of Deep Blue Sea and Cliffhanger, because that'll just pack them in from miles around.
No one should be packing in for any of that stuff. No, yeah.
No, it's good.
But I like Deep Blue Sea.
Oh, yeah.
Gina Gershon.
Gina Gershon is, I think, is Tanto's ex, and Burt Reynolds is like the crew chief. Also, I think he's paralyzed for some reason. They never explain that. Oh, also the love interest was like this blonde Australian chick.
Estelle Warren. I'm the whole camp already.
Yeah, like I feel like she was supposed to be a bigger star than she ended up being.
I know her from something else. Planet of the Apes was her big, like her biggest movie. Ooh, 2011, she had 3 parked cars with her Toyota Prius and then fled the scene.
She dated Tiger Woods at that time?
She did get a DUI.
She was his type.
She got a DUI.
She was his type. I mean, she's working at IHOP. Yeah. What are we talking about? Oh, yeah, Indy 500. Yeah. I don't know.
I didn't even know it was on, so this was kind of shocking news. But
well, yeah, it's interesting, like, the big time events, cities take on of history, like like the entire state of Indiana goes to the Indy 500. It's a big deal. Then you look at like the Preakness in Baltimore. That's a big deal. Kentucky Derby, obviously. I kind of wish Minnesota had something like that, just like an annual event that was here, but
that everyone would go to.
Yeah, it's like a national thing.
State Fair.
I hate the State Fair.
And I do.
Yeah. All right. What's next?
For the record, I think the State Fair brings probably just as much, if not more, than all those events. All right, next up, Val Kilmer is excited for Top Gun 2. Yes, there is going to be a sequel. Tom Cruise has been backing it up, and now Val Kilmer is. Now, you can take this with a grain of salt, because a lot of movies enter this whole, what's known on Wikipedia as production hell, you know.
Who's up there? Cougar and Merlin and Maverick and Goose.
Great.
I've never Maverick seen this movie from Super Nuts.
Great. Watch the birdie.
Oh my God, Polaroid.
Jeez, I crack myself up.
Son, your ego is writing checks your body can't cash. You've been busted. You lost your qualifications as section leader 3 times. Put in hack twice. By me.
That is my. Oh, is that the principal from Back to the Future? The bald guy? Looks like Humpty Dumpty.
Could be.
I'm pretty sure it is. Yeah, maybe he's in every 80s movie. It's possible.
I don't know, I've only seen Top Gun like in bits and pieces and stuff. I know we actually sat and watched.
I know at the end they start World War III, essentially. I mean, they just have a dogfight with some Russian MiGs.
Yeah.
And then they shoot him down. And that's the end of the movie. And then they celebrate and they're like, hold on. Hold on, dude. This is like at the tail end of the Cold War. You just started World War III. It's on. Like, Red Dawn is actually the sequel to Top Gun.
Ooh, maybe.
Yeah. Red Dawn and Top Gun occur in the same universe.
I never thought of that. Wait, Tim Robbins. I'm looking on the Wikipedia page for Top Gun. This is kind of an all-star cast, if you think of it.
Mm-hmm.
You have Tom Cruise, Kelly McGillis, who, I mean, all-star, I mean, you know, she was in, like, every other 80s movie, and then nothing since. Val Kilmer, obviously The Doors, and the fourth best Batman, maybe fifth? I'll go fourth.
I think Batman Forever is underrated. It really is.
Always.
It's not bad. I grew up with it because I love Nicole Kidman.
Okay, I guess it's my turn, isn't it? All right. The bet is...
Come on.
...anymore when I kiss... your lips.
There's no tenderness like before in your fingertips.
This is actually the unofficial theme for my co-ed business fraternity that me and the wife were in. Because it was formed around the time this movie came out, and they just sort of picked it up and they ran with it. It's kind of neat.
You're trying hard not to show it, baby.
But Kelly McGinnis, you're barely going to work anymore.
Baby, believe me, I know it.
You lost your 80s looks. Oh, your 80s looks. You lost that big hair, and now it's gone, gone, gone. And you got replaced by Michelle Pfeiffer. Nick, what's your favorite Righteous Brothers song?
Not that one. Okay. I'll be straight up honest. I always thought that Hall & Oates was a cover of that song, and I always thought it was this.
It didn't Val Kilmer gain a lot of weight?
Yeah, he looked kind of the picture that he tweeted. If it's really him, I'm kind of terrified.
Yeah, because isn't there a picture that turned to a meme of him like sitting at a cafe, like having a beer, and it's just like, woo! That's good. He looks like Bane.
Yeah, for people who like this movie in the 80s, you know, these young oncoming stars, you know, you gotta have like a if you're gonna do a Top Gun, it's got to be a remake with new guys. Get Channing Tatum or get frickin'.
Well, what do you think?
Find Skinny Jonah Hill or something.
So, Kilmer, is Anthony Edwards gonna be in the sequel?
He could definitely use a word. I miss Anthony Edwards.
He's got the ER money. All right, so Val Kilmer and Tom Cruise, what do you think their roles are going to be? Because Tom Cruise will just have like a super mini cameo, right? Like, he's not going to be full bore in this movie.
I mean, I'm assuming they're going to be trainers or something, yeah. Or they'll be like taking over the older adult guys who are, you know, who yell and give them crap too much. And there has to be a bunch of new rookie young kids or something. Like, Zac Efron's going to fucking come in, try to be like, I can fly a plane, whatever. And
Zac Efron, Miles Teller, Josh Gad, because why not? Even though I don't think he would make the Air Force weight restrictions. How many people do you think signed up for the Air Force after watching this movie? Like, there had to be a huge bump.
Oh, I bet there was.
Yeah. All right. What's next?
All right. Last but not least, a funny internet story has been going around is Google search figures out that Wisconsinites cannot spell their own name. This one website from the Duluth News Tribune lists a bunch of the most misspelled words, I guess, brought to us by Google's News Lab team, like how to spell. Yeah. And Minnesota, we can't spell beautiful.
Oh.
But Wisconsin cannot spell Wisconsin.
Well, it's because they're all too drunk. And also their education system sucks, and I can't speak either.
I don't know. So I'm looking at this map right now, yeah, Google Trends. So let's see. I can go over some of the states here. Washington, pneumonia is the...
Who can really spell that?
Okay, South Dakota, college. Come on, guys. Unless you have trouble knowing the college versus college.
I mean, aren't they supposed to have good school? Like, Augustana is supposed to be all right, isn't it?
South Dakota?
Yeah.
Maybe.
This is South Dakota, right? I feel like every hot chick from my high school class went to Augustana for some reason.
Nevada, available. Makes sense, because obviously. Cause...
My life is brilliant.
Wait, so Massachusetts, I can't see it, or West Virginia, but it's like listed as Super Cal. I'm assuming the word is supercalifragilistic. Expialidocious.
Yeah.
Obviously, that's probably the most misspelled word of anything, but I think they search it more in those two states. West Virginia and Massachusetts. I think it's Connecticut. Yeah. Rhode Island, liar.
In a crowded
North Carolina,
place.
Angel. K- Chaos Tennessee.
Wait, liar like liar, liar Jim yeah. Carrey or liar yeah. like the like
liar,
the
liar Jim Carrey.
Oh,
I'll
never be with you. This is a great song. Whatever happened to James Blunt?
Smoked some blunts, I think, and just got wasted. I think I learned on a guitar once.
I mean, this is a good song. Except, I feel like when douchebags learn this on guitar, no offense, Nick, just yeah. kidding, and tried to pick up
just
chicks
kidding.
With tried to pick up chicks with this "You're Beautiful" song. I even think like chicks, even the most susceptible ones to guitar douchebag, saw through is like, this is a little bit pandering. Yeah, I mean, you really doing a song called "You're Beautiful"? I mean, come on, you stop right. He really sounds like Rod Stewart.
A young Rod Stewart.
Yeah. Before he drank all that semen. In a
That's so funny. And I don't
know what to do. All right. So we can't spell beautiful, except we are beautiful. Especially our ladies.
Iowa cannot spell vacuum. Louisiana can't spell giraffe. There's a lot of weird ones here. New Hampshire, diarrhea, and Vermont, Europe.
That's random.
Yeah, but the main thing to get out of it is beautiful. Multiple states have trouble spelling it. It looks like, I think, Kentucky there, California. Yeah. So,
Utah, word they can't spell, assed mouth. Because they keep putting in the two instead of the T-O.
You want to guess what that word, what word it really is?
What?
Disease.
They do have a porn disease because they're very restrictive. And then people act out when they're at home. And then they open up the incognito windows. Like, yeah. Yeah, they can't see that. That's the news.
The news with Uncle Nick.
For the entire Channel 4 news team, I'm Veronica Corningstone.
And I'm Ron Burgundy. Go f*** yourself, San Diego.
And our new friends at Lisa Sleep, the wife and I just got a new mattress, and one of the biggest complaints that she had is that the old one, the old school with the box spring and all the coils and stuff, that every time I moved around, because I'm a tosser and turner, tossing and turning all night, that she would be able to feel everything. Now, this isn't like that stupid infomercial where they put a glass of red wine on the bed and they jump up and down and then the glass of wine doesn't move. It's not like that. But then again, it is like that. And the wife said that she's had the most restful sleep, and I've slept a lot better as well. And you will too. Lisa Sleep shipped right to your door. You just open it up, you roll it out. And it's 80 pounds. Yeah, it's a little bit hefty, but you can handle it. And they also have 100 nights guaranteed. If you don't like it, you can send it back. Get your money back, except you won't. You won't. Because it breathes, it's firm, it's a fantastic mattress. Go to Lisa.com, and if you use code Andy, A-N-D-Y, four letters, get you $75 off your purchase right meow. Do it up. Lisa.com, L-E-E-S-A, code Andy, A-N-D-Y, $75 off your mattress. Nick, what you got coming up this weekend?
Oh, this is my first weekend. I am living in the good old southern suburbs until my place is
Nick's
ready.
Nick's rocking the suburbs. Just like Quiet Riot did.
But I had a busy week at work, so I'm going to be going in, putting a little OT in, make a little extra money.
Money's always good. Also, always good is telling a friend, hey, hang out with your buddies this weekend, your lady friends, all your single ladies, be like, there's this show. It's like morning radio every day in podcast form in 1 hour. Yeah. But with Andy Carlson. Also his buddy Nick. iTunes, Stitcher, iHeartRadio. Follow Nick on Twitter at Nickison. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, all at Andy Carlson Show. Cranking out a lot of good stuff there. Thanks, producer Ali Sorensen, for making us not sound so stupid today. But for Nick, I'm Andy. Sing and Young. Sayonara and bye-bye. Have a great weekend. Talk to you Monday.
Listening to Bull with Andy Carlson. Minnesota's 87th best daily podcast. Download the show on iTunes. Everyone's middle name is Jerome.